So, David, my final question for you is, although we talked about personal value alignment with the company when job seekers are applying, besides that, if you can elaborate more, what three tips you can give to job seekers that will elevate them or make them unique when they're applying for a job?
Yeah, I would say, well, the first thing is bring your, you know, remember that from the second that you are applying for a role, you are being evaluated. Okay. So if you're going to apply for something, like it's interesting. A buddy of mine has a company, he'll put an ad out and he'll get 20 or 30 applicants and he'll call them all back. And maybe four or five will return his phone call. Right. And you just sit there and scratch your head as why did the person even apply for this? So number one, if you're going to go after an opportunity, take it seriously. Do your homework up ahead of time. Make sure this is something that you want to genuinely pursue. And then show the company the respect and yourself the respect it deserves to see it through. So,
yes,
because you are being evaluated from the second you apply. Don't ever forget that. A lot of people think, you know, oh, they'll only evaluate me when they see me. No, it's everything and how you present your resume, how you follow up. Second thing is show up and bring your A game. Do your homework, do your study. Focus on talking about your character as much as you do your skill. Come in prepared.
Yeah.
Ask lots of questions. And I always say to job seekers, remember, you're evaluating the company as much as the company is evaluating you. So you've earned the right to ask a lot of questions.
It's a two-way communication. It's a two-way communication.
Yeah. When I got interviewed at Nurse Next Door, I showed up and they said, do you have any questions? And I said, yeah, I had 52 questions.
Wow.
that I wanted answered, right? Because I knew that if I was going to join them, I was going to give it a significant part of my life. Another little tip I would always say is when you do your follow-up, I never am a fan of sending an email. I always do a handwritten card. I think that sending a handwritten card to a potential employer is a bit of a lost art form, but it's such a nice touch and it will make you stand out in the crowd.
Yeah.
And then, it just insists upon seeing the business from all aspects before you make, you make a decision. Because again, you're going to be giving a significant part of your life to this. So make sure that you have done your due diligence and your homework. So, you know, I would just say, take the opportunity seriously, bring your A game when you show up, evaluate the company, you know, give a thoughtful card at the end, show your character side as much as you do your skill side, and then just sit back and make an informed decision, right? But treat the company as you would like to be treated as well. And you'll make a good emotional connection.
Yeah, those are great tips, David. But I also want to ask you, let's say in terms of the alignment, let's say if one of my core values is creativity and the company I'm applying doesn't have creativity, does it say that I should not apply? Does it mean that all my values should be aligned or maybe three or four of them? What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say you shouldn't apply, but it would be something that I would during the interview process, if that's near and dear to you and that's something that gets your engine going, then I would make sure that I ask questions around that. And it could be something that you could introduce to the company that they might be lacking. They might embrace that, or they may just not be a company that puts any value on that. And if they don't, and that's near and dear to your heart, then you're probably not going to have a long-term relationship there.
Yes.
If it's an element that's so important to you that's missing, you're going to be struggling every single day. But the way I look at things is maybe there's an opportunity to come in and inject that into the soul of their company and they would embrace that. So, you know, make sure that you focus in on that. But yeah, I mean, those elements have to be there for you to be enjoyed, because otherwise what's going to happen is if they don't, you're just going to start resenting going to work and then you're going to be out looking for your next gig. So, but treat it as an opportunity. Say, how, you know, if they're lacking this, how could I maybe be a person that could come in and spearhead this for them? And they may very well embrace that. So I would explore that more as an opportunity.
Yes, great. Again, thank you, David, for sharing your knowledge with me. And with that, my interview with you comes to an end. Again, thank you for taking the time to ask you those questions, especially nowadays, culture is becoming a key element in determining where to apply for job seekers and for employers how to present themselves to the world. And if you like the videos, please like and share, subscribe to my channel, reach out to our social media platforms, mine or David. And if you have any question, as I mentioned, please leave it in the comment section. And tune in next week for another interview series with me. With that, have a great day. Bye.
Thank you. Take care. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye now.